18.
I think what's great about it is at least my initial thought is there's a lot of people coming in, and we're creating, I think, a really good training environment. So actually, at the same time, we have a great facility. The mindset of others is really starting to change, and the fact that we're really training at a higher level. And you can see all the different areas we have in our facility, whether it be the biomechanics, physiology or nutrition, strength and conditioning, which is behind me. It's all there to kind of put together a comprehensive training package for our athletes, and also for our coaches to be able to come in here and talk with our scientists and others about how do we create a better performance environment overall. Our Sports Institute staff, we're starting to plan our strategy as we move forward, specifically about how do we deploy our scientists to different competition sites, basically having a small command center back here, and then how do we then look at all the data that's coming in terms of the results, and then how do we then create the different daily reports and whatnot to get back to our stakeholders. In the near future, we'll have our altitude house up and running. It's a house that will be able to change the altitude anywhere from sea level all the way up to 5,000 meters. And based on what the inputs from the physiologists with their coach, we'll see what is the right level of altitude to set, how long they can stay there prior to their training and competition phases. The environmental chamber will actually be able to assimilate anything, heat, humidity, altitude, I mean a whole host of different things while the athlete is training. So we think that, again, it will be able to actually be able to duplicate what they may see in the real world environment as they're competing.